you know, their commitment to cut spending, and knowing full well that for the last 2 months, we've had to bring this president kicking and screaming to the table to cut spending.
But an even larger fight may be coming. The nation is about to run out of money, maxing out its current credit limit of about $14 trillion, a limit that Congress has increased time and again. The president will push for more, but some conservatives in Congress are in no mood for racking up an even larger debt.
And we will hit that debt limit as early as next month or maybe as late as this summer. But if it happens, the U.S. could default on its debt payments. In Washington, Doug Luzader, Fox News.
Yeah, and here to talk more about the budget battle and some other hot topics, this political analyst Tom Serafin. We were just discussing this. What were you saying?
I said that's where all the battle is going to be in the next 5 weeks. That cap right now, the $14.3 trillion, and it's just like getting another credit card. They want to go higher, and the Republicans are saying we can't go higher because we don't have the money. The Democrats say we have to go higher, otherwise we'll take the markets and everything else into a double dip recession, maybe a depression. So those are high stakes.
Explain why they feel the need that they have to go higher. Is it the entitlement programs, or what is your take on
that? Well, we just don't have the money, so we have to borrow some more. And frankly speaking, if you take a look at it today, without the cuts, we have to borrow more money. And so the battle over the $38 billion cuts that we just saw over the weekend before, an hour before the government shut down, all of a sudden that solved a small problem. But the big problem is we need to borrow some more money. And that's where they're going to play bluff poker. We're going to go down to the stretch. The Republicans want to cut. The Democrats say they want to cut. We'll see what the president has to say on Wednesday. He's got to appeal towards the middle. If you take a look at the Wall Street New York Times poll over last week, you saw that 36% of the people in this country want to wait until the next election day to make up their mind whether they vote Republican or Democrat. 28% say they're going to vote Republican, 31 say Democrat, but 36, the big middle. And that's what Obama has to bring into his court in order to win again his reelection campaign.
How much of a problem is that going to be for him?
What's a big problem? 36 is sitting on the sideline right now. They're taking a look. Let me see what's going on. And right now the Republicans are kind of disorganized on the presidential end, except for Donald Trump, who seems to have some kind of focus is going right at the president. And that's, everybody looks at it with a kind of a sense of humor, but I think he's serious about it.
And we want to rewind a little bit because we were talking about poll numbers where Donald Trump tied for second with former Arkansas Governor Mike Huckabee. On the
right.
Republican side, Mitt Romney still leads that poll. What do you think the chances are, the Donald versus President Obama?
Well, nobody thought President Obama was going to be able to beat Hillary Clinton. I mean, the only thing in this business is certainty. So, I mean, nobody knows what's going to happen. It's hard to imagine that Donald Trump could be president of the United States of America, or that Barack Obama could be beaten by him. But everybody thought George Bush back in 92 was going to win re-election, and Bill Clinton was this guy from Arkansas that was just kind of going about it the wrong way, and he became president for 8 years. So, the world is rudderless right now, leaderless. And Paul Krugman, the Pulitzer Prize winning columnist for the New York Times, an Obama supporter from day one, said yesterday in the New York Times, the president is missing. Where is he? This was a terrible deal. So when you have supporters like that talking about what you just accomplished, you have to wonder, I think they're going to go with Obama. The left, they have to go there. That's where the Democrats are going to be. But he needs to capture the majority of the middle. And right now, the middle is sitting out. They're looking for someone of compromise. They're looking for someone who's going to make an effort to solve this problem. 70% of the poll in America want to deal with the deficit issue, want to deal with the economy. 70%. That's what the president's going to try to do on Wednesday.
I'm going to talk about the ROM issue and the city council trying to usurp some of his powers before he actually takes office. Good or bad idea, in your opinion?
Well, not a good idea, but I think what he's trying to let people know is that he's putting together his contingent of aldermen, the people that he can take and work with to get his agenda move forward. It's an exciting time because you're going to actually have participation. It's going to take a year before everybody settles out and everybody understands where they're going to be. But right now, I think Rahm's in the driver's seat. He's got vision. He's got kahunas. He's willing to spend political capital. A few people around town today are willing to spend their political capital. They don't know if they're going to get more of it. He knows he's going to get more of it. He's close to the White House. His good friend is running the White House right now. His good friend is the president of the United States of America. His good friend is running the best political operation in the world, Dave Axelrod. So he feels pretty comfortable where he is.
And he was clearly elected by a majority of the citizens of Chicago.
54%, I think it was. He didn't lose a precinct in the African American. He lost one precinct in the African American wards. Did a nice job on the north side. He's got to work with the Hispanic community.